Many papers have explored the extent to which relative income affects an individual's well-being. That is, whether people care not just about the absolute level of their income, but also about how it compares to others. This issue is particularly salient when it comes to the debate over income transparency. Proponents argue that forcing governments to make data such as tax records publicly available allows citizens to police their public figures and limit corruption. But if happiness depends on relative income, what are the potential costs of these policies? Are we better or worse off if we can easily compare our incomes to those of our friends, family, and neighbors? This paper uses the case of Norway to estimate the effect of income transparency on well-being. Tax records in Norway have been publicly available since the 19th century, but historically required an in-person request submitted at the tax agency. This changed in 2001 when the Norwegian media digitized the records and created websites allowing individuals to search through them. Suddenly, every Norwegian with internet access could find out the incomes of everyone else in the country. And the opportunity was not wasted. Surveys indicate that at least 40% of Norwegians used the online search tools. Data from 2010 show that Google searches for the tax lists are especially elevated, even surpassing searches for YouTube, in the third week of October, when the tax lists are updated with new data from the previous year. And while transparency may facilitate legitimate oversight, the evidence suggests, and users themselves admitted, that the lists were primarily used to snoop on social contacts. This figure uses data from one of the tax sites and shows what kinds of profiles account for the greatest share of search traffic. Prominent individuals, measured here as those whose profiles were visited at least 100 times, account for less than 3% of total traffic, while the vast majority of searches are for profiles that receive only a handful of visits. Moreover, users visiting more than 100 profiles per session account for only 0.27% of total visits. This indicates that individuals, rather than entities such as mass marketers, were the primary users. Most tellingly, a regulatory change removed anonymity in 2014. After that point, any individual could identify who had searched for their tax records, a change which led to an 88% drop in the number of searches. What impact did income transparency have on individuals' well-being? The author compares subjective well-being between richer and poorer individuals before and after 2001, the year in which the online tax lists were first made available. This allows him to quantify the impact of transparency on the happiness-income gradient, which corresponds to the slope of this line, and summarizes the extent to which being richer is associated with greater self-reported happiness. If transparency increases the gradient, this indicates a widening gap in well-being between richer and poorer individuals. This figure shows the estimated evolution of the gradient over the 1985 to 2013 period. Each point corresponds to the change in the gradient relative to 1997 through 2000. Pre-2001, the gradient remained constant, but then increased after the online list became available and remained high thereafter. The corresponding magnitudes point to a 29% increase post-2001. This suggests that increased transparency substantially widened the gap in well-being between richer and poorer individuals, but a potential concern is that the effects may be driven by something else that happened in 2001. To address this, the author shows that the post-2001 change in the gradient was entirely concentrated among individuals with higher internet access, who, presumably, would have been more likely to use the online tax lists. Moreover, the same analysis reveals no change in the happiness income gradient in Germany over the same period. thus the changes in Norway cannot be attributed to shocks, such as the dot-com burst or the growth of IT, that were common to both countries. Finally, higher transparency had no effect on the average level of well-being in Norway. This, combined with the increased gradient, indicates that the online lists led to a transfer of well-being from poorer to richer individuals. So, why did greater transparency widen the gap in well-being? The author argues that one channel, though by no means the only one, is changes in self-perception. Other research has shown that individuals often perceive themselves to be closer to the middle of the income distribution than they actually are. If transparency corrects this misperception and leads poor individuals to realize that they are poorer than they thought, and rich individuals to realize that they are richer than they thought, this can widen the gap in well-being. And, indeed, transparency in Norway increased the gradient between perceived and actual income ranks by 8.5%. In other words, transparency led rich individuals to perceive themselves as richer, and poor individuals to perceive themselves as poorer. In line with this, transparency also increased the gradient between income adequacy and income rank. The rich became more likely to view their income as adequate, and the poor became less likely to do so. In conclusion, this paper provides evidence that transparency widens the gap in well-being between rich and poor individuals. A back-of-the-envelope calculation suggests that income comparisons accounted for at least 22% of the happiness that individuals in Norway derived from their income during the period of higher transparency. While this points to the potential cost of disclosure policies, transparency is not necessarily bad. Rather, the author argues that policymakers should consider alternative ways of publicizing information that can reduce the adverse consequences. For example, via de-identified datasets, or via aggregated data that sufficiently mask individuals. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related research. This includes work on relative income and well-being, papers studying individuals' misperceptions of their position in the income distribution, and studies evaluating information disclosure in other contexts, including salary transparency at work and political contributions.